Today the topic of interest is RFID. RFID means radio frequency identification. So we are going to use radio frequency waves. So we will see what is RFID. RFID tags are small chips. Usually comes on a smart card or visiting card chip. So it will be roughly the size of visiting card or ATM card. It will the size and thickness will be more or less same, that are used in our day-to-day life for unlocking hotel rooms, entering into cars, etc. These tiny chips along with an RFID reader forms the RFID system. That is, you must have a RF reader and RF transmitter. You have two types, passive and active. In passive, we use coils. So coils, you know, transformer like coils. So two coils will be placed very close together. The information from the source is received by the receiving coil. So it is passive, and the distance of coverage is very, very less. That is, it's very close. You have to place the transmitter and the receiver very close, say 20 mm or 2 cm or sometimes less than 1 cm. That is passive. But in the case of active, we use chips, supply, transmitter, receiver. So the transmitter will transmit the coded signal and the receiver has to pick up. So we have two types in RFID, radio frequency ID. One is using induction method, that is two coils are placed very proximity to each other. And the other one is active. Active means you have to put a battery supply, you have to give a DC supply, there will be a microprocessor, microcontroller. It is programmed, it can identify the individual person identification. You can transmit, okay. The distance of transmission depends upon the power of the transmitting antenna and the size of the system, okay. So this RFID plays a vital role in especially in door unlocking, so the identification of the person. So remotely also you can control a system. So these are some of the uses of RFID system. So generally for active RFID, we go for 433 megahertz or 915 megahertz. This is frequently used. Okay. Whereas in passive, we are not going to use any such. It will be data is very. It's very proximately we are placing the two coils. Therefore, through induction, two mutual induction, magnetic field, it strikes the another coil and get the information. So this RFID principle can be employed in different application, and by careful designing we can locate the identification of a particular person, system or any other things. So that's all about the introduction for RFID, radio frequency identification tags. Thanks for watching. Nandri.